Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny talking rejuvenation or jawline injections. Very, very common. It's just in Asia, we're making the jawline smaller but more projected forward. They want a triangular look, and it's one of the things you can do. I want to show you in a video here what you can do to extend the jawline. We did a video on filler underneath the mentalis, but here we're going to use radius along the jawline. Let's go and see it now. I'll narrate it through for you. So I like a micro cannula here, and I think it's safer. A 22 gauge is really the one you want to use, and a 2.5 inch or 2 inch depending on the length of the jaw. Make your opening. You're in front of the masseter. Know where your facial artery is. That's key. You pop into a nice plane. You don't need to be periosteal, but you can be anteriorly, just not posterior because of the masseter. So here, the patient needs to be sitting upright. You see the pre-gel. I'm injecting in front of it, and I'm moving back and forth to get the shape that I want. Calcium hydroxylapatite or radius is really nice. You can see as I'm filling, it's thick. We want a razor sharp jawline. You can mold a little bit, and you can immediately see we extended it a bit, but we got rid of that pre-gel. Now, here I'm going to make the opening in a different direction because I'm going to inject posterior. So I make the opening, and then just make sure, again, you know where the facial artery is in front of that masseter, but really we're more superficial. We know there's a lot of aberrancies in vessels, so it's better to be superficial, but it doesn't mean you're 100% not there. Now, we want to extend the jawline back. My finger is on the angle of the jaw, the gonial angle. So I know where I want to be. As we fill back here, it's going to pull the face back. So the oral commissure will improve because we're filling, pushing the tissue back. I want to create a nice slope here. And in a female, the angle is going to be just say around 120 degrees. There's a whole separate video on that, but that's a good number to know. Again, with calcium, we want to make this sharp. People ask, what product do you like? Whatever product you like that has a high G prime, of course calcium is one of the highest, actually the highest we do have. And here you can see we're forming the back or the posterior at the gonial angle. I'm putting a fair bit of product because there's a fair bit of loss. And females lose bone, and that's really what we're playing off, the existing bone. And you can see, even without a before and after, you can see how much straighter it is and how we created length. So that's the patient's right. We go to the left. The left is often different than the right side, so we have to assess it differently. But you can see where the pre-gel is. We want to inject in front of there. The patient's still going to need PlasmaSculpt and PlasmaBoosters to tighten the skin above the area, and of course our neuromodulators such as Botox and Dysport to stop the downward turn in the mentalis. But here we fill. We create that opening again. We have a nice long cannula. We never touch the cannula with our gloves. And I'm injecting in front of the pre-gel, always watching to see what lift I'm getting. You never know. You don't know for sure how much you're gonna need. And when people say, how much does it cost? I don't know what I'm gonna need. This might fill easily and my product goes very far. The tissue could be tense and I need more product than I think. There's no way to tell people or estimate a cost. It's just one of those impossible things. We're result focused, not price focused. Now I come up, I can actually fill the melomental fold. So here I saw a hollow, I come up, I fill. I'm injecting little aliquots, always moving, and that's why I don't have to pull back on the plunger. Cannula's safer, but also creating a potential space with those little aliquots, and here I'm filling the front. And just molding a little bit, not a lot, or you'll lose your angle. Now you can see a platysma band there, and I'll put neuromodulator in that. Again, how much does it cost? Well, you're gonna add neuromodulator for sure to that platysma band that you're seeing. But I wanna concentrate my filler back at the gonial angle. You can see she has a fairly upright angle, probably around 110, 115, and 120 to 140 is nice for females, so we can have a little of an upslope here and still have a nice feminine look. Here I'm advancing the cannula. You're going to hit some resistance, especially if they've had Sculptra or PMMA here in the past. Now, I want to extend her jawline because it's a little short. So by adding posteriorly, it will give more length in appearance to the jawline. So filling, adding the calcium, going back and forth. And now I'm coming up more near the preauricular area because my angle was somewhat upright here. And the right side will be different than the left just because of bone structure. Come fairly posterior to grab more length. A longer jawline is more attractive in general, and it makes the cervicomental angle better as well. So filling back here and through all through one opening because I have a long cannula, 2.5 inch, 22 gauge. Now, sculptor's a collagen stimulator, and so is radius. So with the radius, I could dilute it if I wanted to go more in the preauricular area. Mold a little bit, and there you have a jawline rejuvenation with radius. If you have any questions on this, ask me below on this YouTube channel and subscribe for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, vibrant.